Father God, I come to you as humble as I know how to say thank you. Lord, I'm so grateful for this day. I will not use it in vain. I will do everything that I know how, using every power in my being to make sure that this day is effective. Lord, if I can only touch one. Lord, my aim is to only touch one. If I can just show that one person how beautiful you are. If I can just convince that one person through my way of action that there is a God and that you are beautiful, Lord, I ask that you allow me to do that. Lord, I just want to take this time right now to say thank you for everything you have done for me. I will admit, taking away my mom was a challenge for you and I. See, at that point, with me knowing how well you know my heart, I didn't understand that, Lord. But you know that. I'm no longer mad at you, Lord. And let me tell you that even then, did you win in the fight? Because I tried my best to turn my back on you. And every time I stuck my foot too deep in, you were right there to pull me out. My heart said thank you. Even though the words couldn't travel up to my mouth, you see, I was still mad at you. So then I started to do different things out of the spirit of I don't care. And in doing so, you show me how much that you do and how much that my life has value. My mother's life still have value, and I'm a fight. She's in me. I'm gonna fight because you, Lord, are in me. You have been that mother. Oh, to the motherless. You've been that person for me. You've been that image for me. And I am grateful. Lord, if I can only just take that one person, Father God. Lord, if you could just guide me to that one person who needs direction, Father God. And not the direction that I can give them in a sense that you can. Just the direction so that they can understand power of you. You, Father God. I give all praises to you. I take no glory in anything that I do before I give it all to you, Lord. You brought me such a beautiful man in the name of a husband. And he takes great care of me. I can't ask for no more than that. Come on, God. You weren't playing fair. Three beautiful boys. When I couldn't stand life itself, you gave me three beautiful boys. I can't stand here and take that glory. Oh, because I know where it came from, Lord. You gave me a reason to live. Through a husband and three beautiful boys. I can't stand here or sit here and take that. Nope. You gave me an uncle like no other. And though many try, not one can take his place. You gave that to me. My mother's baby brother. She took care. She loved her baby brother. I respect that too. Because you taught my sister and I how to love like no other. And I know that they love me and I love her right back. Through my sister, it is no formal discussion. We are totally off the records. And I love her for it. My sister has my back and I know that. And I appreciate her for that. present. You understand what I'm telling you? That's a present. Because I've seen situations close to home to where siblingship means nothing. God don't judge. And I'm so grateful for that. I just started to read the Bible, and I was asking people, what should I start? What should I start? What should I start? I'm hearing Psalms and Proverbs. Where I started with Psalms. And for any of you non-Bible readers, or for anyone who just want a good read, who just want to feel good about who you are, like, I can't lie to you. This is what I do. Start here. Go to your table of contents and find Psalms. And then just start there. And as you're doing it, get your pad. Okay? You see, because I was doing it, then I was finding myself researching more than I was remembering. So I said, let me get my pad. Let me write down some notes. Let me be a reader. Let me understand what he's trying to tell me. And through understanding, I know that God is so good. He's so good. I teach every day. And I love what I do. It's hard now. But I love it. And I teach it with everything in me, but I know that I need my own reading program to be the successful person that I want to be. See, at the beginning, God put teaching on my soul, and now that I have the credentials to allow me to teach and be effective, thank you, Lord. Lord, I just have to take this time right here in this moment and just say thank you, Lord. Lord, if you can, just direct my path, Lord, to one. To the one that needed, then use me. I have no fear in what you can do. I give all praises to only you. Through my mother, you used that to let me know that I fear no death, Lord. When it comes to me, I will be ready to accept it, even if I ain't ready. Because I know in my heart that I belong to you, and you to me. So I'm going to see my mama again. And the people that I lead here on this earth, no doubt, I'm going to see them again. The people that are waiting on me in heaven, there is no doubt that I will see you again. Lord, while I stand here and fight this fight here on earth, guide me to that person. I want them to see you in me. I don't want to convince them of what religion to choose and denomination. I get it now. No disrespect to not one of them. Because it all comes back around to you, Lord. And I know this. So I can't fight that fight. That's not my fight to fight. I pray. Pray so gentle for any atheist. How can you not see the glory of God in your everyday? Now stop right there and take that time to reflect. I wait. God is too good for you to allow yourself to deny that fact. I love you, Lord. I need you, Lord. I seek you, Lord. In your name I pray. Amen.